Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a quick look at the NASDAQ Top 10 Volume Leaders from Monday's trading action. Let's start off the presentation by looking at the NASDAQ 100 ETF, the Qs. We're 3 cents away from generating a buy signal. Yesterday was very uncomfortable. We had a huge rally off Friday's big decline, but we had no volume yesterday, and so that's still kind of spooky. Looking to break out of this triangle that we're forming here, a 100-day moving average is still acting as support. Looking up, you can see the recent high that we made last week, which was a lower high. Of course, that's bearish, but then we made a higher low last week, so that's bullish. So right in the middle of that range, take last week's high, take last week's low, break out of that range. That should give us a clue which way we're heading next. Our first stock this morning is Apple Computer, and Apple Computer generated a buy signal yesterday, still didn't break out of the triangle that it's forming. So we are back on a buy signal. If you want to give Apple a little more room, then move to the midterm chart. You can see momentum is just dried up here. There's no trend whatsoever in Apple Computer right now. And so a close on Tuesday above 128.12 would give us a buy signal on the intermediate term chart. Next up, we're looking at Microsoft, which has been on a buy signal for a while. First area of resistance was the March highs. We ran into that yesterday. If we can take those out, mathematical target 43.75, and then the February highs for Microsoft. Looking down on Tuesday, a close below 41.32 would give us a sell signal. Next up, we're looking at Advanced Micro Devices. This stock's been all over the place over the last couple of days. Ran up to 293, then dropped like a stone, clustering around 254. If that breaks, if the Friday's low breaks, look for a move down to 215. Looking up on Tuesday, we need to close above 275 to give us a buy signal. You know, after you get slapped around a couple of times like this, there's really no reason to rush in. Look for a close above 290 to give us a buy signal on Tuesday for Advanced Micro Devices. Next up, we're looking at Facebook, and we had the recent early warning signal there. We're still projecting lower prices, but Facebook is holding its own. We drove up into the channel yesterday, looking for a close on Tuesday above 83.17 to give us a buy signal for Facebook. Cisco Systems still on a buy signal here, trying to take out last week's high. If we can do that, look for a move up to 29.69. On the downside, on Tuesday, we need to close below 27.71. And of course, that lower channel line is continuing to move higher daily. Next up, we're looking at Intel, still on a buy signal here, still trying to get out above resistance. You can see we had a high there, and we're still trying to break out above those. If we can do that, look for a move up to 34.38. On the downside, we need to close below $31.59 on Tuesday. Sirius Satellite Radio is our next stock, and of course it's still stuck in this channel. 391 is the midpoint, 391 is where we closed, trying to break out above $4 or below 381. On Tuesday, we're looking for a close above 395 to give us a new buy signal. If you want to give this stock a little more breathing room, then you can wait till we get to below 381 to pull the trigger and sell the remainder of your position. Next up, we're looking at Micron, and Micron is still on a buy signal. Still can't break away from 28.13. If we can take out this high, then look for a move up to 29.69. On the downside, we'd be sellers of this stock on Tuesday with a close below 27.43. Next up, we're looking at Comcast, coming off that early warning signal. We drove down hard on Friday, didn't generate a sell signal. We traded in the channel yesterday, so we're still looking for a sell signal here, and we need a close on Tuesday below 58.35 to give us a sell signal. Next up, we're looking at Zynga, and Zynga, after dropping, has been treading water, so we're basically been trading inside this bar's range ever since the big drop. We need to close on Tuesday above $2.58 to give us a buy signal. If we take out that recent low at 234, look for a move down to 225. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Thank you very much for your time and attention. And next time you'll hear my voice is on Wednesday morning. And at that time, we'll take a look at the stock market and the New York Stock Exchange top 10 volume leaders from Tuesday's trading action.